ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति 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 ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम् सर्ववेदांत सिद्धांत गोचरं तमगोचरं गोविंदं परमानंदं सद्गुरुं प्रणतोस्म्यहं। हरि ओम। सैल्यूटेशंस टू ऑल। We saw the signs of a Jivan Mukta, of a realized person. Now, very often the question is asked about what happens to the karma of the Jivan Mukta. Because for an ordinary Jiva, one is bound by one's own karma. And to fulfill those karma, to exhaust those karma phalas, one has to take birth. And so we have seen the ignorance cycle leads to the vasana cycle, leads to the cycle of birth and death. So if ignorance is removed, then what happens and how does that person's karma pan out? So before we go into that, just a quick recap of what are the three types of karmas. So first and foremost, karma, the equation for karma is equal to action done with the body, mind, intellect plus intention plus doership. Whatever I do with my body, whatever I feel with my mind and I think with my intellect, when it is done with appropriate when it is done with an intention, the motive of that, the intention, the quality of that intention determines the good or bad karma. Or what we call as the motive of the action determines what is a good karma or what is a bad karma. And when it is done with the sense of doership, then that karma phala belongs to me because I am the karta. So I have to be the bhokta. If kartritva bhav only is not there, then those karmas don't affect. But that's a very high state. That's the state of realization where kartritva bhav goes away. And unconsciously in our daily life, many things happen where kartritva bhav is not there. So there are two possibilities. So in human life alone, this self-awareness is possible. So only human life, we create karmas. In other lives, we don't create karma. Plants, birds, animals, they are only bhogayoni. They can only exhaust the karma phalas. They don't create new karmas. Even devata, yaksha, gandharva, kinnara, any of those. So if somebody says, how did we come to human then, if they didn't create karma? Nature pushed and brought to the first human birth. After that, it is our free will. So as a human being, what all karmas one has done, which have not given the results yet? In so many lives, I may have done so many karmas. The total bank of karma, which has not given result yet, that is called my Sanchit Karma. Chi, chinoti means to collect. Sanchit means that which is collected very well. Over many lifetimes, many karmas which one has done, many human lifetimes, many karmas that one has done, which has not given result, that is called the Sanchit karma. Out of that, whatever is ready to give result, to experience which I need a particular body, it can be any body, it can be plant, animal, bird, human, demon, anything. To exhaust those karmas, a body is taken. Those karmas are called prarabdha karma. And then while exhausting the prarabdha karma, as a human, if I do actions with the sense of doership and intention, then what happens? Those actions which give result immediately, then they are finished. Those that transaction is over. But those which have not given results yet, one cannot escape from karma, because the law of karma is simple. The doer has to be the experiencer of the result. So what happens to those karmas? Those will get added to the Sanchit karma. If they start yielding results, they become a part of prarabdha karma. If they don't yield result, they are added to the Sanchit karma. These basics of karma, we have done this earlier also, but just to revise, because the three types of karmas will now come for the realized person. So every human life can become a source of adding more new karmas or exhausting the existing ones, and then reduce the vasana pressure, reduce the karma pressure, and sit quietly, contemplate, realize the truth. Now here is the Jivan Mukta. We saw the signs of this Jivan Mukta. What happens to the karma of that Jivan Mukta? If that person has awakened to realize, I am pure consciousness, I am Brahman, but we still see the person experiencing the world, then how is that happening? So yesterday we saw in the in verse 445, the example of the roasted seed was given, and then the example of the mother was given here. Two examples. So roasted seed will not sprout even if the appropriate environment is there. And then the example of the mother was given, that even the most passionate person in the presence of the mother will not engage in such actions. So here also, the person who has realized absolute consciousness, the worldly things won't affect. But will that person experience the world around or not? Now, if you remember the Sapta Jnana Bhumikas that we have done, in that Turyaga is the highest one, where this person is so absorbed in that bliss, and the karma of that person is such that there is no way, there is no coming back into this world. They won't come down to body consciousness at all. Body will just drop. They are in Brahmic bliss. So we are not talking about those kind of masters. We are talking about those who have some karma left. Whose karma it is, the body has to go through, and that jiva had done some karma in the past. Now this jiva has realized the truth. But karma phala has to be exhausted. So now what will happen to the three types of karma of that jiva? So it begins here with the prarabdha karma in 446. See, though the section is titled prarabdha for a saint, it will cover all the three types of karma for the saint. So you see this. Nididhya sanashilasya bahya pratyaya ikshate braviti shrute. Braviti shrutire tasya प्रारब्धं फलदर्शनात् निदिध्यासनशीलस्य. नाउ द निदिध्यासनशील मीन्स somebody who is steady in contemplation. बाह्य प्रत्यय ईक्षते. When that person comes out of that state of contemplation, one is still seeing the world around. Bravīti śruti etasya. So what does the Veda say? Why is this person experiencing this? Through steady contemplation, that person experienced the samadhi avastha. Savikalpa or nirvikalpa, any of these. Now that person experienced. But when that person comes out, first of all, why does that person come out of that state? That itself is a question. That prarabdha karma is there to exhaust. That's why that person came out. Having come out of that state, identified with the body, then one sees the world around. So prarabdham phaladarshanat. So that's the reason given here. The Veda also says it is because of prarabdha karma only this person has come out. Otherwise, person will remain in that state. You know, if you remember the Saptajnana Bhumika, the sixth state is where this person comes out only because some other people push that person out of it. Not because of some internal desire or internal vasana pressure. The fifth state is that. This is that fifth state. You see, this is the Saptajnana Bhumika, right? So in this asamsakti which is there, here you see the person comes out of this nirvikalpa samadhi because of one's own vasana pressure. Padartha bhavana is there, this person comes out by other people making this person come out. Now if somebody asks, how can these other people only make some karmic connection will be there. Of course, there is some karmic connection between this person, these people, and this master. That's why they are there and then they are doing some actions persistently and this master comes out of that state. But Turyaga is the avastha where this person doesn't come out only. He is absorbed in that state and then from there only out. Body is dropped and one goes. In Jiva, Videha Mukti happens for that person. So we are talking about this state right now of either Sattvapatti, where is experience of Nirvikalpa Samadhi has happened and then again one comes down to the body level, or Asamsakti, where one comes out of the Nirvikalpa Samadhi of one's own vasana pressure, or even Tanumanasa we can say. Nididhyasana Shilasya can mean that also. But we don't say Tanumanasa because the person is still a seeker. These other four are realized people. So we are talking about the realized person here. So in general, we take the Sattvapatti, Asamsakti, Padartha Bhavana and Turyaga. Those four. Because the realization of all the four is the same. Only difference is in the karma of that Jiva which has already started. That's the prarabdha karma. Because the entity otherwise is dissolved. At that present moment, that entity is already gone. But now the karma of that entity was there, which already started. Prarabdha means what already began. That one cannot stop. So that is how this person comes out of samadhi and then one is able to see. One is able to perceive this world. So then the question is, how is this person experiencing? Why is this person experiencing? Because of prarabdham. Prarabdham phala darshana. Now, which is the Shruti which is saying this? If somebody asks, then this Chandogya Upanishad says that. See, naha vai sa sharirasya priya apriya yoho apahatihi asti. Meaning, there is no cessation of the pleasant and the unpleasant experiences for the one who has body consciousness. To whatever little extent that body consciousness is there, to that extent the world will be perceived, and so the pleasant and unpleasant, priya apriya yoho apahatihi na asti, that Chandogya Upanishad says. And the same Chandogya also says, tasya tavadeva chiram yavanna vimokshyase, yavanna vimokshye atha sampatsye. We say, Chandogya says that there is a delay in complete absorption, whereby then there is no other perception. Only as long as that person is not delivered from this body consciousness. The moment that person is delivered from body consciousness, the karma is over, this person will get absorbed in Brahman. So that's why this Braviti Shrutihi. Shruti means the Veda. So the Upanishads, the Vedas, they explain this, that it is the Prarabdha which makes this person come down to body level. See, we are naturally in this body level state. We think of ourselves as a jiva. Here is somebody who knows I am Brahman. But still they come down to body level, pushed by some past karma. Whatever is the vasana pressure, karma is there. It need not be something which is like how for us it may be some things to enjoy or some desires or some karmic connection with some people. It is not like that. It may be for Loka Kalyan also that the body is to be kept alive. So they may still perceive the world, but as we have said, it is like the roasted seed. It will not sprout. So this, them coming down to body level does not mean they come down to jiva level. Please remember, they remain as Brahman only. But the body is equipment. Ishvara may be using this body for some good of the people. As well as whatever the prarabdha of this body has to go through, it will go through. But it will not generate new karmas. Also, it will not make that person deluded that I am the body. Those two things don't happen. For us, those two things happen. We live in the body as the body for the body. And so because we live as a jiva, we create more karmas. They don't live as the body, they don't create new karmas. Still body is there, so some karma one has to identify if one comes down to this body level. So that ahankar is called badhita ahankar, because somebody will ask, if body is there, then jiva bhav will be there, then how that person is realized Brahman? Body is there, so jiva bhav is there, but the jiva bhav is falsified. That is called badhita ahankar. That ahankar is a myth. Falsified ego it is called, not a myth. Actually, it is called falsified ego. Like the actor knows, I am not the role. Completely the actor knows I am not at all the role. Still the actor plays the role very well. It's like that. So this is the prarabdha of the saint. That why the saint comes down to body level. What is the difference between them and us? They don't have jiva bhav. They live with brahma bhav. They don't create new karmas. We create new karmas. For them there is no cycle of birth and death. For us there is a cycle of birth and death. They have an ego which is falsified ego. For us, the ego is very real. So these are differences. Now remember, falsified ego means the world also is falsified for them. Like the whole movie also is false only. The actor is playing his role, but the actor knows that everybody else also is playing their own role and this is not real. For us, this world is still real because I is real, this world is also real. For them, it is not real. And hence, for them, because they have falsified their ego, they see everything as Brahman. We still see everything as jiva. So though it appears that they are doing actions like us, they are not doing actions like us. The state is very different. And that's why when looking at them, we should not just blindly copy. Oh, he is also eating sweet, I'll also eat sweet. Are ba? अरे बाबा दिस ईटिंग स्वीट फॉर देम एंड फॉर अस इज कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट. ओह ही इज ऑल्सो वर्किंग दिस मेनी आवर्स, आई विल ऑल्सो वर्क दिस मेनी आवर्स. नो इट डजंट वर्क. देयर होल स्टेट इज डिफरेंट. सो नाउ दैट इज अ प्रारब्ध. सो वन मोर श्लोक कंटिन्यूज दैट थॉट फ्लो हियर. 447. सुखाद्यनुभवो यावत् तावत् प्रारब्धमिष्यते फलोदय क्रिया पूर्वो निष्क्रियो हि नहि कुत्रचित्. सुखादि अनुभवो यावत्. सुखादि मीन्स ऑल द सुख दुख भय शोक ऑल दोस वट एवर अनुभव जनरली अ जीव गोस थ्रू एज अ कर्म फल. So he says, as long as the all those experiences this person is going through, sukhadi anubhavo yavat tavat prarabdha mishyate, so long that it's a result of prarabdha only. Falodaya kriya purvo. If there is a phala, there has to be a kriya before that. Meaning, if there is an effect, there has to be a cause before that. Nishkriyo nahi kutra chit. A result is not produced just like that without any action. If there is a result which is there, there has to be some action before that. That's the simple law of cause and effect. So he says, that is what is the reason that why is the Jivan Mukta going through some of these results? Because that's a prarabdha of that Jivan Mukta. It's a result of some actions done in the past. Now, this if somebody says, why this prarabdha karma of this person is still there, if jiva bhava is dead, that is called prarabdha. Further, it will come. But if somebody says, why is this karma even there? Because as long as the karta is there, karma is there. If the karta is not there, karma is not there. Here the karta is gone. How can there be prarabdha existing for the saint? That's the nature of the prarabdha karma. It is already begun, so it cannot be stopped. So that example comes ahead. The arrow is shot. Now once the arrow is shot, now you can't change the direction. It is shot. It will go and hit the target wherever it has to hit. Before releasing the arrow, one has the control. After releasing the arrow, there is no control. It will go and hit. Same way, the nature of prarabdha karma is that prakarshena arabdha, what has already begun. Now, in between one realizes, then what can one do? What has begun has begun. So prarabdha will be there. But as we say, the Jivan Mukta goes through that prarabdha karma phala without any attachment at all. So there is no impact of that on the Jivan Mukta from standpoint of realization. Externally, you may see some impact. The Jivan Mukta, you may see smiling, laughing, crying also, sad also. Though you may see that, but remember, it's all the role. Is all falsified. Badhita ahankar it is not real. From the Jivan Mukta standpoint, from Brahman standpoint, they know I am Brahman, none of this is me. The body has to go through, it will go through something. Karmic connections have to be fulfilled, it will happen. Now, prarabdha will be continued a little later again. What happens to the total bank of karma? Because prarabdha is a result of that total bank. Now, this is very interesting. The only way to get out of karma cycle is through knowledge and through contemplation. There is no other way. Why? Because every karma I do with the sense of doership will create new karma. No, what if I do good karma? Even good karma will create karma bandhan only. Why? Because good karma also creates a limited karma phala. No? Anything done in the realm of action, in the realm of time, is limited. So suppose I do charity and I go and help the poor people, the migrant laborers, and so many in this COVID relief work. It's a good thing one should do. That will not destroy my past karmas. That creates new good karma. So mind becomes more purified, sattvic. As long as that sattva guna lasts, mind is in sattva. If that sattva guna goes away, again mind comes back to its own rajas, tamas, whatever it is. So good karma also creates, no doubt it is better than bad karma or no karma. But it is also a bondage only. Because to experience the karma follow of that, I have to again take body. And good karma, definitely that punya karma, what we call, is responsible for getting a human body, plus the comforts in the human body, plus the satsang in human life, the ability to contemplate, all that is a result of good karma. So good karma cannot be negated saying ki don't do any good karma at all. But good karma is not a way to remove or get out of the cycle of birth and death, because it is still karma and it is actually responsible for continuing the cycle of birth and death in a certain sense, where I do good karma for experiencing the good results. Because many who do punya for one's benefit in terms of what we said, either a human body or going to heaven or, you know, getting comforts in the next life or even getting satsang. So karma cannot cut karma. And definitely this mutual cancellation doesn't happen in karma, that also we know. 100 good karmas and 200 bad karmas, so net result is 100 bad karma. No. That net, this offsetting doesn't happen. To experience the result of this 100 plus 200, 300, I will have to take body. So there is no way to destroy this karma bandhan by doing karma. Because every karma creates new vasanas. Those create new karma. So now the cycle goes round and round. So what to do then? The only way to come out of this is realize I am not the karta. So that equation, if you remember, karma is equal to action done with BMI plus intention plus doership. Now, how much ever intention may be pure, till doership is there, it is my karma and I will have to experience the result. But if the doership is gone, dissolved completely, when will that happen? In the samadhi avastha, when I realize I am not the karta at all, I go beyond the three, drashta, drashya and darshan. The seer, seen, seeing, the actor, action and acting, actor, all these three gone. Triputi is gone. Then all the karmas also will go. So that is what is said here now in 4:48. Aham brahmeti vijnanat kalpa koti shatarjitam sanchitam vilayam yati prabodhat swapna karmavat. Aham brahmeti vijnanat, by this realization that I am Brahman, kalpa koti shatarjitam, karmas which I have created in 100 crores kalpas. What is unit of time? This is 100 crore kalpas. One kalpa is 4 yugas. 4 yugas means 43,20,000 years. That is one kalpa. 100 crore. 43,20,000 into 100 crore. In that many human lives, not in that much period of time, because we said it, karma can be created only in human, meaning that many times I must have been born as a human being to fill this much expanse of time. In that time, whatever karma I have done, which has not given result, that is all the sanchit karma. Imagine how rich we are. From in the karma bank, if you see, each of us has like this unimaginable amount of karma which one has done. Huge amount of karma. which has not given result. All those sanchitam vilayam yati, they all get burnt. How? Aham brahmeti vijnana, by realizing I am Brahman. Jnanagni sarvakarmani bhasmasat kurute Arjuna. This fire of knowledge will burn away all the karmas. You see, one spark, one matchstick of fire, one spark of fire you put in a huge stack of hay, what happens? Burn to ashes. Like that, this is Aham Brahmeti Vijnana. By this realization, through Nirvikalpa Samadhi, not intellectual understanding, through the Nirvikalpa Samadhi Abhyas, when this person is abiding in the self, not coming down, see, going into that state, that also destroys, there's no doubt, karma gets destroyed. But abidance in that has sealed, fully destroyed. Sanchit karma fully destroyed. Vilayam yati. Sanchitam vilayam yati. Laya means temporary dissolution. Vilayam means gone, fully gone. It will not return. So sanchitam vilayam yati. How? Prabodhat swapna karma vat. Like the actions of the dream, they end completely when one wakes up. So here it is that. So how to destroy this sanchit karma? Not by any amount of karma. Only through the fire of knowledge. That I am Brahman, I am not the karta. Because if the karta is gone, then that file is closed. Like that example we generally give, no? The criminal who is awarded, let us say, 25 years of punishment. Now if that criminal, it dies at 5 years. What happened to balance 15 years? File closed. Now what to do? Can't say ki don't die before this. He died. So in that way, this jiva is dead. So whatever karma was there, sanchit karma, burnt away. Now there is no cause for new birth because that is over. So that's what happens to the sanchit karma. Now the example given here is elaborated here in this 449 when it says prabodhar swapna karma vat, just like the example, the dream, when we wake up from the dream, all karmas end. In that same way, the entire bundle of sanchit karma collected through so many kalpakoti shatarjitam, all in this human life, whatever one has collected, burnt. Imagine what level of vairagya this should be. So vairagya does not mean only that this world I am having dispassion about. It means I also have dispassion from this small I, ego. That this ego is I am not this ego. It is actually the cause of sorrow. And it is unnecessary that I think of myself as this ego and I am suffering. But it also means vairagya from whatever karma I have done in the past. That is called detachment and dispassion. Generally, we don't discuss so many things because how people will understand all this. Just you think about it. Are we not attached to the past? The amount, see, money, let us say a simple example of money. It has an example limitation because financial utility it has. But it applies to many things. It applies to money, it applies to memories, it applies to things we have collected in the past. Emotional attachments we have, this person gave this to me, that person gave this to me, all this, you know, that is all the past memory and the attachment we have to it. So the hard work I may have done, got some money, built a house, or even, you know, had so many relationships and spent some such nice time with people, those all turn out as memories. Now we get attached, no, to the past, meaning the result of my past action is all this. Now I have to let go. Now imagine in one life for me to let go of my past, what I have collected in this life. That only is not easy. This is Sanchita Karma of so many lives. Somebody may even have moha of that or not. That, you know, Swamiji, this life went in so much of sorrow and struggle, but I think in my Sanchita Karma, there must be some good karmas I must have done. I want to experience result of that. I also must live like a royal person, you know, and with such comfort and luxury and enjoy and travel and do this and that, you know. Must be there, na? Some karma I must have done. So that attachment to karma will still be there. So when he says, Iha Mutra Phala Bhoga Viraga, actually the definition includes the Sanchit Karma also. Iha means here, Amutra means hereafter. So the results of one's action, Phala Bhoga Viraga, the craving to enjoy the results of one's action here and hereafter. That is not happening only because of Prarabdha Karma. It is happening because of Sanchit also. Because hereafter means what? After this body drops, the Agami Karma is added to Sanchit, then that is what will take me ahead. No? So dispassion means actually that also, that I have no attachment to the past karmas and I am happy to let go. Whatever it may be, compared to Brahman, this Sanchit Karma and whatever good karma may be also there. How much we fight in this world for my right and my this thing, and it has its relevance in the world. I'm not saying no, but a human being does or not. I deserve it. I have fought for it. I have worked for it. I must get it. Now imagine this Sanchit Karma. In one life, for a few days or few months or few years, one has worked and then one feels so much of ownership of that. That this is mine. How can somebody deny me this? This is my right. This is a right of Kalpa Koti Shata. Sanchit Karma. Jeevan Mukta is not bothered only. Why Jeevan Mukta? Sadhak only is not bothered. That's how he becomes Jeevan Mukta. Whatever it may be, I don't care. My nature is Brahman, full stop. I am not this at all. That is Vairagya. Because a Vivek has been done. Atma, Anatma, Vivek is done. This is Anatma. And the reason for sorrow is this Anatma only. This identification with Dehatma Bhav. I am this, that is the cause of my sorrow. So attachment to, now you think about it. What level of detachment this is? It's not detachment only from the world outside, from the house, from the money, from the people, from, you know, the karma of this life, all the karmas collected in the past, Sanchit Karma, gone. Not out of any pessimism or suffering, here life is all full of misery, so why? Not out of that, out of Vivek, out of clarity. No doubt that this whole samsara is finite and it is a cause of misery only. That clarity comes, but it is not a pessimistic outlook. Not a defeatist, escapist outlook. It is an outlook out of, born out of Vivek and clarity, that no matter how great the enjoyment is in this world, it is still temporary, it is sorrow only. It is postponed pain, that's it. What Buddha said, no? Every pleasure is pain in disguise. It is just pain in disguise. So one has seen through all that. So one says, whatever Sanchita Karma also has, can it bring Brahman? It will not. It will only give some finite pleasure, either here or in some higher worlds or lower worlds, wherever it will be. How does it matter? When my nature is infinite pure consciousness, how does it matter that what is my past karma, whatever I have collected? It may be anything. That one part of that karma may make me even the emperor of the whole world. So, I will still have Dehatma Bhav and I will still die, I will still have misery. So, how does it matter? This deep Vivek is done, so dispassion will arise from that. That is how in steady contemplation, this person is able to get this knowledge, absorb in Nirvikalpa Samadhi, and Sanchit Karma is gone. So that is the role of Vairagya. Vivek and Vairagya have a very powerful role. We generally undermine it. We don't cultivate that Vivek and Vairagya also strongly. and we try to go to higher steps without developing that vivek, vairagya, shatka sampatti, mumukshutvam in their intensity, one goes on trying to read more and more Upanishads, more and more the prakarana granthas or the Vedic literature, etc. Nothing wrong in doing swadhyaya or study of any of that, but this fourfold qualifications have to become more and more strong. So now this Sanchit Karma of this Mahatma is burnt in the Nirvikalpa Samadhi through the abidance in the self. The Sanchit Karma is burnt. Example given was like the dream karmas, all are burnt when this person has woken up. So that extension comes now. That analogy is explained in 449. यत्कृतं स्वप्नवेलायां पुण्यं वा पाप मूलबणं सुप्तोत्थितस्य किं तत्स्यात् स्वर्गाय नरकाय वा. यत्कृतं स्वप्नवेलायां, व्हाट इज डन इन द स्वप्न इन ड्रीम स्टेट, पुण्यं वा पाप मूलबणं, इट मे बी पुण्य और इट मे बी पाप. Suptothitasya, when this person has woken up now, kim tatsyat, what happens to all that? That karma will just dissolve. What swarga, what naraka? Because that swarga naraka is a part of that swapna. He is woken up. Whatever karma he did, good karma, bad karma, in the swapna, will give the result of that swapna as heaven or hell in the swapna only. But if this person has woken up from swapna, then what karma, what heaven, what hell, what will this person experience? He is woken up saying, "Arre, it was all mithya." There is no question of any karma phala to experience there. Now that example is powerful because we should know that this swarga and naraka and these all 14 worlds, everything is a part of this illusion. So good karmas will lead to heaven, bad karmas will lead to hell. All that is relatively real. As long as the body is real for me, I feel I am the body, world is real. This sphere, relative sphere, is also that much real. And the laws in this sphere will apply. So one cannot say I am a Vedantin and I don't believe in this karma because I am not the jiva at all. Till the experience of that doesn't happen, I am still acting as a jiva, no? I am still having hunger and thirst at the body level. I am eating, drinking, enjoying. If I am detached from the body completely, then anyway the question only doesn't arise. But if I am living at the body level, then this is real. Here is somebody who has dropped the body identification, who has woken up to realize Brahma. So from the sleep, one has woken up. So when that dream, from that dream one has woken up. So when that dream example is given, whatever is relative in the dream, everything ends. So here 14 worlds are the relative aspect. And because of the Sanchit Karma, whenever some part of karma is ready to give result, one will go into any of these 14 worlds. But that whole karma only is destroyed now. So karma also gone, lokas also are gone, the future births also gone, all. Just like when one woke up from the dream world is gone, the dream karta is gone, all the dream karmas which were done, they are also gone, and future dream experience also is gone. Then what is remaining? Waker, who is freed from all the sorrows of the dream and the relative existence. So that is what it is. So now these two verses spoke about Sanchit Karma. Earlier two verses spoke about Prarabdha Karma. Now what happens to this Agami Karma? Remember Agami Karma, we said those karmas which have not given results yet. So this Agami Karma is divided into two. Those karmas which I do right now, which give me result already, or which are in the process of giving result, they are a part of my prarabdha only. But I have done some action, but result has not come yet. then what happens? They will become a part of Sanchit Karma. And they will manifest as Prarabdha whenever time has to come for it. So all those karmas are called Agami Karmas. Now what happens to the Agami Karma? Agami Karma is created because I am the Karta. This person has no Karta Bhav. But karma is still happening. So then what happens to the Agami? You see, 450. Svamasangamudasinam parijnayana bhoyatha nashlishyati chayat kinchit kadachit bhavi karma bhihi. So bhavi karma is the word here to indicate agami karma. Bhavi karma is agami karma here. So svam asangam udasinam. Being unattached and being indifferent, having known oneself, one becomes unattached, indifferent. How? Nabhoyatha, like the sky. Sky means space, not affected by anything that happens. You know, air can get polluted. In space, whatever is, that can get affected. Air pollution, land pollution, water pollution, all that can get polluted. But space will never be affected by it. So, na shlishya teacher. Yat kinchit kadachit bhavi karma bhihi. So, they don't get affected. They remain like this, unattached. So, now unattached meaning what? They remain unattached to. If, remember two types of karma we said. Agami is divided into two aspects. One aspect is if the result is already a part of their experience right now, they are experiencing the result, or it has started giving results, so it's a part of the prarabdha karma. So this asanga and udasina means that while going through the result, they are completely indifferent, unattached, not bothered. So when we go through, we get affected, we are attached, and we are not indifferent to it. So for us, while going through the result, we are adding new vasana. For them, it goes through the prarabdha and they are anyway detached toward the prarabdha. So there is no question of any new karmas rising out of it. That's why unattached and indifferent, they go through it. Now, what is not giving result yet, that has got added to Sanchit Karma. Now, what happened? Sanchit Karma already got burnt. Now comes the interesting part. So, Sanchit Karma is already burnt by realization. Now, for whatever prarabdha this body has to go through, this Jivan Mukta is perceiving the world. Now, this person is doing some karma. As I said, one is a part of the karma. One part of Agami Karma is that which will give result, or which already started giving result, that will come through the prarabdha. So that the Jivan Mukta will go through with being unattached and indifferent. But if that karma doesn't give result now, where will that karma go? Because Sanchita is burnt. Now what will happen to that karma? The Jivan Mukta, having realized the absolute truth, now he is acting, and those actions don't give result immediately. So they can't come through prarabdha. They can't get added to Sanchit also. Now what happens to that karma? Here is not said very, very explicitly, but what happens? From Tattva Bodh, we have to take a reference. The good karmas will go to the devotees. The bad karma will go to the critics. Oh, this is so unfair. The Mahatma is not willing anything. He is not saying, my good karma, let this person take, my bad karma, let this person suffer. For that person, everything is Brahman. There is no differentiation at all. But in the world, this is the law. One will attract what one thinks about. What kind of mindset one has, one will attract those things. The devotee has positive bhav, devotion, love for the Mahatma. So the good things come. And this nindak goes on criticizing and thinking negative. So if at all some negative karma arises out of the person's existence, then those will go to the critic. The Jivan Mukta will work for the benefit of both. The Jivan Mukta works, serves both of them. Jivan Mukta has no partiality. But the law of nature is such, it will go. Because karma has to bear result. If Karta is dead and Sanchita cannot be added to and it will not come as a part of Prarabdha, then somebody has to bear it. Who? The devotees. That's why the Ninda of a Mahatma brings more bad karma. Unnecessary one is polluting one's own mind. And the Stuti of the Mahatma also brings that much more. Punya. Not because the Mahatma needs any stuti, that is to purify our mind. You see, one grain of rice that Krishna Bhagwan took from that Akshay Patra, and Durvasa Muni and everybody got full. You know, their hunger was appeased. Why? Because when Bhagwan eats it, it is like feeding the whole world. That's why dana given to a Jivan Mukta is like dahan given to the whole world. The punya of that is that much. In quantity, it is this much only, one grain of rice. But when the Lord is consuming it, it fulfills all the jivas. So that's why the Jivan Mukta is like that. That whatever agami karma is there of the Jivan Mukta goes through that with complete detachment when it comes through the root of Prarabdha. So the example of sky was given. So that example is again explained here in 451. And whatever is not being added to Prarabdha, which can't be added to Sanchita, that the devotee and the critic will exhaust it. So now that example which was given earlier, that we will see. Nanabho ghata yogena sura gandhena lipyate tathatmo padhi yogena taddharmairnaiva lipyate. Nanabho ghata yogena. The sky doesn't get affected by what is there in the jar, in that pot. Sura gandhena lipyate. It may have liquor inside it, but space is not contaminated by the liquor inside that. That is in the pot, and the air may be affected, but space is not affected. If you move that pot from this place to this place, now this place is not bad. Space I'm talking about. The smell may still be there, but that's because of air. But the space is not affected. So in that same way here says, Tatha Atma Upadhi Yogena Taddharmaihi Na Upalipyate. Whatever may be the conditioning, the body, mind, intellect, and whatever karma phala it may go through, the Atma is not affected by any of that, and this Jivan Mukta is already one with that Atma. So now, having spoken about this much, we have seen the two verses about Prarabdha, two verses about Sanchita, two verses about Agami. Now one comes back to this question about this Prarabdha Karma, that this Prarabdha Karma of this saint, how is this Prarabdha Karma still there? because Sanchita is already burnt away and Prarabdha should have also ended. See, we should remember this. If Prarabdha karma, if the realization destroys even the Prarabdha karma, then no Jivan Mukta we will be able to have experience of. We can't know what is Jivan Mukti because all Jivan Muktas will die. Why? All karma dead. All karma finished, so this person died. No. That's a big problem. Nobody will want Jivan Mukti after that. Why? Because you will die. It's not like that. The Prarabdha karma is already begun. The arrow example that I gave you, that is there in this 452. That this person, it is good that this person is there. Because at least then one knows ki what is the Jivan Mukti sthiti, how does the Jivan Mukta live in this world, how they live this unattached and indifferent way, and how they are in the same world which is a source of sorrow, misery, agitation, conflict to all. Here is somebody who lives absolutely unaffected. So they become examples for all of us. If this Prarabdha was not there for that Jiva, for that Mahatma, then Sanchita gone, Prarabdha also destroyed, Agami destroyed, this person gets Vidya Mukti instantly the moment that person realizes. And also that will falsify law of karma, that what has already begun also will end instantly. So that is not possible. So that's why this arrow example is a example to clarify that. 452. Jnanodayat purarabdham karma jnanana nashyati adatva svafalam lakshyam uddishyot srishta banavat. Jnana udayat pura arabdham. Jnana udaya means the dawn of knowledge, means before realization. Pura arabdham, whatever was started before. Karma jnanam na nashyati. See this, purarabdham karma, one has to split there. Whatever karmas were done before realization, those karmas, jnanana nashyati, they don't get destroyed by jnana. Adatva svafalam laksham, without giving its result, they will not get destroyed, one. Second is, laksham uddishya utsrishta banavat. How? It is like the arrow which has been aimed at a particular target and left. Now when there is a target in front, I put the arrow on the bow and then I pull it, the string to the ear, and then leave. I have control only till I am holding that arrow. The moment I leave that arrow, then I suddenly realize, oh God, the target is not what I thought. Now I can't change. The arrow is gone. It is shot. It will go and hit. So that is that's explained ahead in this 453. That how if one feels that this is a wrong target, then one can't change. It will go and hit. Vyagra buddhya vinir mukto bana paschatu go matau natishtha tichi natyeva lakshyam vegena nirbharam vyagra buddhya vinir mukta bana. Now one thought that is a tiger, and one aimed and one left the arrow. Paschatu go matau, then suddenly one realized, oh God, that is a cow. Natishtati chinatyeva laksham. This arrow will not stop. It will go and hit the cow. How? Vegena, with the same force it will go. And nirbharam, it will pierce. It will go and pierce the cow with the same force with which it was left. Meaning, this karma cannot be stopped just because one realized later on. See this, it happened na, in Krishna Bhagavan's case also, in Dashrath Raja's case also, Pandu's case also, all examples like this only. Dashrath Maharaj thought it's a deer drinking water and he hit one Shabda Bhedi Baan, and then it went and hit this Shravan Kumar. The Pandu Raja also thought it is some animal there, and he hit the arrow, and it was that Kindam Rishi there. And this Jara, this hunter, he also thought it is the mouth of a deer, when it was actually the feet of Bhagavan Krishna, and this arrow went and hit the thumb. All the three examples like that. After releasing the arrow, when one suddenly realized, oh, this is not the target, then what can one do? One cannot stop. Meaning, the karma which has already been done before, it is like the arrow. Now that karma has already been done, the karma phala to exhaust it, this body has been received now. So this body is literally like the arrow. That Sanchita karma, whatever karma I had done in the past, now which is a part of Sanchit karma, that is the bow. From that, the prarabdha, this arrow, is ready to give result now. Now it has, the arrow has been shot. Now where it will go? It will go to the target, meaning it will exhaust what has to be exhausted. That one cannot escape. Even a Jivan Mukta will not escape that. Why? Because adatva swafalam. It cannot not give result. Then the whole law of karma will get falsified. So it will give result. Only thing is the Jivan Mukta goes through it with complete indifference. It is not my prarabdha, it is prarabdha of the body. I am Brahma. So this is the karma of the Jivan Mukta. How the prarabdha, sanchita and agami, they work out. So when the prarabdha of the body is exhausted, then the body of the Jivan Mukta will drop. That is called Videha Mukti. So Jivan Mukti is when this person got abidance in Brahman while living here. Then the body still exists. And remember one example we saw earlier. What is their attitude? It is like the attitude of a buffalo towards the garland on the neck. It is literally like that. Jivan Mukta, the body is hanging around. If it falls also, the Jivan Mukta doesn't bother. It of course affects all of us, but the Jivan Mukta is beyond it anyways. So that is called the Videha Mukti. So for today I will stop here. Anything to ask, you are welcome.
Narayan Swamiji.
Haji.
This Padartha Bhavana, what you said, can we give the example of the Buddha? The Buddha was went under a tree and doing the sadhana, and then he was not taking care of his body, and then the villagers or the old lady came and awakened him and said, okay, you take care of your body and give the food and things. So is it the same thing?
Maybe to a certain extent that can be said, because in this situation here, this person wakes up from this nirvikalpa samadhi by the effort of other people, persistent effort of other people. You see, because the body is anyway sustained by the karma as well as by Bhagavan himself, as well as by the bliss that they experience in samadhi. So if the devotees around, they may want to feed the Mahatma's body with something. So with great persistence, they may wake him up. So yes, to certain extent, we can say yes.
Or maybe Ramakrishna Paramahansa.
Same. All of those examples can apply. Same examples.
Thank you.
Swamiji, we have been given three paths, with karma, bhakti and jnanamarga. But in this, it is only talking about the jnanamarga for realization. Then what about the other two parts?
Please remember that all the four parts, karma, bhakti, jnana, raja, all are preparations. Contemplation is the only way to realize, either through contemplation or surrender. I had said in one of the classes that these are the only two ways to realize. That contemplation on the self is the direct path to realization. Either the jiva will do by himself or herself this contemplation, or Bhagavan will bless that jiva with the knowledge where he says that dadami buddhi yogam tam. So these four processes, the karma, bhakti, jnana and raja yoga, they are preparatory paths. The direct path is only contemplation and self-knowledge. Now contemplation on the self, that is the only path. All the four will come to that path. If you read the commentary of Gurudev, third chapter, third verse, Gurudev explains this very clearly in that. Lokesmin dvividha nishtha pura prokta mayanaka. Jnana yogena sankhyanam karma yogena yoginam. So there is a preparatory means and there is a direct means. In cooking, preparing the vegetables and washing them and cutting them and all that is the preparatory means. Fire is the direct means of cooking. One may do any amount of preparation, but if the fire is not there, cooking will not happen. In the same way, these four paths are preparatory paths, including Shravan Manan Nididhyasan in the Jnana Mark. But after that comes this absorption through Samadhi and all that. That is same in all the four marks because that's the direct path. In yoga also samadhi is there, bhakti also samadhi is there, karma also samadhi is there and jnana also samadhi is there. So through steady contemplation and samadhi, one can attain. So that's the direct path. There is no other choice there.
Thank you, Swami.
Yeah. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.